He shoots off his mouth so much he must eat bullets for breakfast.
Notice and fighting with a gang up bonus. Oh, that's why it's
awesome.
Individual. As
did like, you add like flavor text to that as well?
I actually did.
Oh, I wish maybe later tonight I can see it. I'm very impressed.
We can go over to like, you know, whenever you have some time too. I don't mind. You can hit me up on Google Chat during the day or at night.
Well,
or
when we do 5e, I just know Bob's going to be all over macros.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, Bob, any time is really good for Adam because he doesn't do much, so.
Unless things change, Mike is absolutely right.
The truth hurts.
I was going to say, I worked with Adam for years. I found him sleeping in the computer room more times than he was working, so.
With his pants on or off.
See, that was working as far as my boss knew.
As far as your boss knew, it was all good, but.
Well, your boss is 200 miles away.
No, not anymore. Now my boss is 2 miles
away. Well, that's because Hovannessy was too busy starting his own business to care what Adam was doing.
Yeah,
so
right.
All right, so when we last left off, back on our last date was 9/14, so 20 days, it's been 3 weeks.
And Josh, you're recording, right? Sorry.
I am recording.
Sorry, okay.
No, it's okay. I am recording. I've been recording for the past minute and 20 seconds. When you guys last played, you've been hired by the wife of Ken Hart to invest. Well, you've been sent over to Ken Hart's place to investigate the theft. Wait a minute.
I thought we didn't have to check that.
Who's that going? There we go.
Raven Bob.
There we go.
All right. Rick Barn is was the head of
Rick
botany.
Barn is
it might be Chris on
the devices. Can you guys hear me
now?
We can hear you now, but you're echoing because yeah. Okay, there we are. There we go.
Yeah, I know.
All right.
There you go. Bingo, bingo, bullet.
So Rick Barron, head of botany and agricultural science at the university, had needed some help. His house had been burglarized. Detective Blaine Bishop was investigating. Insurance would cover all the damages and loss, but he was missing a hook that he believed belonged to
Long Gun Silver.
Bloody Jim.
Are we going to find the hook hanging on the door handle of the car?
No. Bloody Jim, the Glenn Mack had asked you to investigate. They're paying you to look into this. You went and looked into Ken Hart, who was a historian of the area who was very big into Bloody Jim. And Ken is missing out in the woods. He had gone out there. You guys went to investigate.
Hey, Josh?
Yes.
I'm sorry to interrupt you, but I think one of us who is remote, maybe Chris, I'm not sure, is not on mute. So I hear like an echo. I'm not sure if you guys are hearing that too.
Is it still echoing? Because I'm muted on my computer.
We don't hear any echo anymore.
No, we're pretty good now.
Unless
no, that's the TV's echoing. Muted, so.
Okay.
All right, well, we'll keep going. If we have a problem, we'll address it in a second. You were accompanied by the video guy, Anthony Hoffman, who was investigating some of the miraculous stuff you guys have been doing, and Roxanne.
Oh, yes, Roxanne.
You went out into the big
Please
thicket.
Please put on the red light.
You went out into the big thicket, which was the woods out a little ways away. Bloody Jim had worked at one of the lumber mills there, and he was a nasty guy. He got in a fight and killed, and supposedly he still haunts the area. And the hook that Ken Hart stole, that Rick Barton was after, was probably, they think, belonged to him. Adam, don't do it.
I just want one square. Not even a whole square.
So you guys went out there, you wandered around the woods, you avoided some Sasquatch, and spent the night in one of the old abandoned lumber mills. You had a map that showed, you had a description that showed five of them. You found the first one. Toward the end of the night, you took alternating watches, and Johnny Moon believed toward the early morning, looking out, that he had seen a man resembling Bloody Jim, carrying his head in one arm, a hook in another, and he was still 6 feet tall.
So
John,
you
have brought some things. I'm assuming you brought some snacks. So it is now the next morning. You have eaten somewhat. some snacks, and it's time to get to work. I will say it was a fairly lousy night. Impossible to get comfortable. The creatures outside were making a ton of noise. Never mind Roxanne snoring. She seems fine.
It was the farting that got to us.
Sorry, guys. I told you I ate a chili.
So you spent the night at the first of five old sawmills in the rough map given you by Ken's wife. No, by Rick's wife. Sorry. Or Ken's wife, I don't know. The creatures seemed to have left once the sun started to rise. All is finally quiet. As quiet as it can be at East Texas University.
Bob's screen, we get a good view of the highway.
Guys, I had the strangest dream last night. I dreamt that we saw like a Sasquatch, and it was like walking around with a tree trunk. It was a crazy dream.
I think we all wait for that. We all see the same thing.
What? That was not a dream?
No.
All right, what about... I also dreamt that there was a ship full of Vikings and they were throwing tiny pickles at me. Did that actually happen, or was that a dream too?
No, Edison,
that was real too.
How big were the pickles?
We were all up for that as well, Edison.
Oh my God.
Sorry, Andrea.
So for those of us joining us, by the way, this is session 9 of ETU. We have a very odd situation in that we moved the night for a couple weeks to be nice to my schedule. Jeff and Adam are the only ones in the house. Chris is remote. Mike is a standard remote. And Bob is rocketing down the highway on his way home from Boston. So yeah, this is probably the most spread out we've been ever.
Ever.
Mike, are you home or far away?
No, I'm home. I have my surgery on Thursday, so I'm not too far.
Gallstones?
Yeah, I've had my gallbladder removed.
Good luck.
Hey, we're pulling for you, Mike. Hang in there, buddy.
Yeah, thank you. Just, you know, it's an excess thing. You know, just get rid of it before it causes more problems.
Yeah, you don't really need it.
No, but you're going to miss fried food.
No, the doctor said, the doctor told me in 2 days, man, I can go back to eating whatever I want.
Which is just what you want to hear.
Exactly. So I'll be at Chick-fil-A on Friday.
Oh, you bastard.
Well, I will say my mother-in-law had her gallbladder taken out last year, and it was pretty quick, 3 days, and she is eating fried chicken and everything that they told her she might not ever be able to eat again without any problem.
Bob, does she have any spare parts?
Hopefully you'll have a similar experience.
I hope so, Bob, because yeah. That's kind of what the doctor told me, too. He said, it's, you know, we don't expect you to have too many issues. So I just hope that they can do it all laparoscopically, and it's just a couple days, and I'm good to go.
Well, tell Starling to take good care of you.
What about all those stones in there? All those rocks?
You're going to lose 5 pounds.
Yeah, there's 30 of them in there. So. Oh. I don't know. I guess they take them out, and they put them in a jar if you want to keep them.
Yeah.
You should throw them. Pretty cool thing.
Yeah, actually, I'm going to ask the surgeon, so.
Hey, Bob, just out of curiosity, where are you? Are you in Connecticut yet? Bob's muted.
Yeah, I think we just crossed the border. Okay, so we're now in Connecticut.
Looks
so
like it.
You're going to get to that dead stretch on 84 where we may lose you. Mm. So just so we know if you drop
good
off.
Good point. And then if it happens, I'll just try to reconnect when I can.
Yeah. So, all right. So it is the next morning. You're all waking up, like I said, a little worse for wear. And you have a vague map of the area. Johnny Moon believes he saw Bloody Jim. And
I immediately checked my pockets to make sure while I was sleeping, Cochise wasn't, you know, hitting the stuff in my pockets.
If anything, Roxanne was going through your pockets playing pool, dude. But anyway,
she didn't go in the pocket.
Roxanne couldn't be near my pocket. She was too busy hanging out with one low.
Middle pocket.
They were snuggling up nice and close.
She's starting to develop a thing for Edison as well.
She was looking for the one low Edison sandwich.
That's pretty much what she had last night.
I believe she got it.
She is on cloud nine.
I turned my back to her.
She is a cloud the size of one.
If clouds were very,
I think
very
she was
dense.
Just looking for sandwiches. Not really particular. She just wanted sandwiches.
There's things called scissors, you know.
Nope. So, all right, and just in case...
Let me tell you, there's things called scissors.
You guys forgot the joy of Roxanne.
You can't make this look. No!
There she is.
No! This is very reflective.
He is so not cute.
I just can't help but show the picture. It's just, I feel so...
It's like a train wreck.
So, anyway...
Do you really feel that bad? I don't think so.
So it's the next morning. You're still tasked with collecting the hook for the reward.
That's rotten. That's
almost 8 years old now.
So I've now changed the picture for you so that you wouldn't have to see it. Back to Texas University. All right, so what are you up to?
This is why we don't do horror very well.
Jeff and Adam might have had a little too much cinnamon whiskey. I'm just saying.
No such thing as too much.
So, all right. So, it's the next morning. It's you're all waking up groggy. You're eating your beef jerky or whatever you took for snacks and water.
I basically tell the girl, I'm like, listen, I ain't spending another night like this, so we need to make this day count. So let's get moving. Let's find this stuff. Let's get out of here before nightfall again. I do not want to deal with those creatures or... Roxanne.
All right, we're up early. I go out and I look to see footprints, if there's any footprints on the side that we didn't come in on, where nobody has walked. We wouldn't expect to see footprints there, but I'm seeing if there's anything there.
All right. What do you got, notice or tracking?
I'm going to go with my notice check.
Do you notice if there's footprints there? I don't really know. I'm looking directly at it, but I don't really know.
Doesn't Johnny Moon have tracking?
Yeah, I was going to say, I thought Johnny Moon had tracking.
Let me replace my D8 with a D4. Hang on one second, guys.
You know, to notice tracks is one thing. To follow them would be something else.
I got a 5.
Yeah, just because I want to be cool, I'm going to roll. I'm going to help him.
Want to know who's going to help?
I could roll a D4 because I had 2 5s. So it wouldn't...
Well, are you using the app?
I'm trying. You know, I'll just do it here.
I made my notice check, if that helps him.
Wallo looks around immediate area. 1.25.
Well,
that's solid.
It's one. It's it's divided by 4, so that's a success.
Over
2 is a raise.
Okay, so you guys definitely see some tracks.
A 5.
It's it did rain a little in the night, so you do see some large footprints. You know, we're talking size 16 size feet.
Humog?
There are both
shoes.
Feet footprints. And you spend a little more time, gentlemen, where you thought you saw the Bloody Jim, and you do see what could be an old boot print. It's hard to make out, it's hard to tell.
All right. Can I see if there's going in a particular direction?
Now you're going to need your tracking.
Are they bloody footprints?
No, there's no blood. I'm getting a look from Jeff. Ooh, I rolled okay.
My D4 exploded. 5.
Yeah, they follow. They traipse off into the woods. You don't see so much as... the one with some of the sides.
We go over some rocks.
I have no idea what that means.
Some of the sides are filed down, so they're a little flatter than the rest. You know, you set file down the one side, you're more likely to see what's on the opposite side, which is the 20. Never mind.
Okay. You spot a couple broken things, stepped on, twigs broken. It's not an easy to follow trail.
Guys, it goes over these rocks over here that I kind of lose it, but it definitely looks like there's some
a trail.
Trails where
that is vaguely in the direction of one of the lumber mills you were instructed us.
I say we should go see the lumber mill that we were instructed to.
Yeah, let's go check out the lumber mill. The other lumber mill.
Alright, marching order.
I'll go first.
Cochise will go first.
We'll both go first.
I'll be looking for the tracks, the scent.
I should write this down.
But yeah, you need to make us think it's important.
Johnny Moon, you can go to, you can go side by side. It's single file, really.
We go as a group of seven across. And we just move forward.
Are you searching the field for a body?
No, we just want to all run into the same thing at the same time.
Oh, who rolled dice on my screen?
Me.
Cool.
It's a 5 and a 3?
Yeah.
Yeah. It shows up on my tablet, too.
All right, so Johnny Moon is taking the lead, obviously, because he's tracking. Who's next?
Juan Lowe's right up there with him.
Okay, Juan Lowe. Joe Diffie, you following up after that?
Sure. You put Edison behind Joe.
What about Journalism Boy? What's Journalism Boy's name?
Ford Friendly. Ford Prefect.
I'll head up the back.
And then the camera guy was camera guy was Anthony Hoffman. And lastly is Roxanne. Roxanne is definitely having a tough time of it.
That's why Juan Lowe's in the front. Chris, are you saying something? Can you talk a little bit more?
We don't hear you, Chris.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay.
Sorry. So I don't even see his mouth move.
Yeah, but I think he's on his phone.
Yeah, I can hear you, Chris.
I'm a ventriloquist.
Skills. Mad skills.
Mad skills, yeah.
That's a radio you hear in the background.
All right.
As long as you only hear it once.
We're not muted.
Hey guys, given what happened last night, I think maybe once all is said and done and the dust settles, we should probably go that shop and pick up some weapons, because this place is dangerous.
Joe Diffie, did you bring your pistol?
Yes, I did.
I believe you did.
I believe you have 7 rounds with that?
I do have 7 rounds, that's correct.
And everybody else has some sort of hand weapon except for Juan Lowe, who just needs his fist.
I do have a pocket knife, but I don't brandish it.
Is it a Swiss Army knife, or is it more of a survival knife?
I forget where we got them from, so I couldn't answer. It's a Swiss Army knife, but I don't use it as a weapon.
Does it have a little saw in it?
Yeah, it's got a saw, it's got the scissors, it's got the magnifying glass.
Did you lose the toothpick already?
No. But you don't want to use
we all,
it.
We all bought Swiss Army knives and a couple other things.
Yeah, you all collected some stuff. I think when you were down in Mexico, you did all collect survival knives at some point. So if you wanted like a something with like an 8 or 10 inch blade,
they let those right through the border.
Hey, where we're going, we didn't
on the bus. They don't care. You know, we were leaving Mexico, so they don't care at that point.
Yes, as long as you didn't bring stuff back, is organic matter back in, they were good.
Yes.
All right, so you traipse through the. Give me another tracking roll. You chase through the woods for another couple hours, following what?
Hours? Holy cow. Critical failure. I'll use one of my 4 bennies that I get. You only gave me 3?
Why do you get a 4th one?
Because I have luck.
Well, you didn't bring dinner, so.
But he's still getting credit for it.
Man, a critical failure, I could have so much fun with that.
Here we go around in circles.
6. All right. What are you rolling for, Chris?
You have to type slash roll.
I'm seeing if I can do it. That's all.
Oh.
You have to type slash roll.
So you wander around for a couple hours. Johnny Moon thinks he's following a trail. Everybody give me a quick notice check.
I'm still here.
Ooh, Ron Lowe succeeds.
Success. I'm not sure what Chris or Mike are doing right now, but they're searching for something. From the sounds of it.
They exploded 15 times? 7.
Wow.
Edison failed with a 3.
All right. So ironically, the guys toward the back haven't noticed, but the guys in the front pause and look around and realize that Roxanne is missing. She'd fallen behind at some point. And is now missing in the woods.
We press on.
We agree to just go forward.
I'm not heroic.
Yeah, I got to be honest. I didn't even notice her, and she fell behind.
I have scavenger as one of my things. Is that
Ford Edison and I were in the lot, back for her. Notice.
Ah, code of honor and loyal.
Are you loyal to her, and does your code of honor include no
left? Anthony feels obligated, but guys, we really should be looking around for her.
I'm going to go back and look.
I'll keep Coach's company.
Oh my gosh, I hope nothing bad happened to her. We got to find her. This woods are dangerous.
All right, so you retrace your steps.
I go back and I look for really deep footprints.
She looks like
Adam disappeared in the men's room, but I'm gonna continue anyway.
My mama taught me it doesn't matter what you look like on the outside; it just matters what you are in the inside.
Listen, the only reason I think it'd be worthwhile to find her is because if those creatures come back again, she might be able to talk to them.
So, Joelle.
One Sasquatch to another.
That's just two Yankees, nothing. Fourth inning.
Oh. All right, so you guys wander back for almost an hour or so, and you find a spot where it's obvious there was some activity. Adam, you wandered around, you wandered back down the trail for another hour or so.
It just occurred to me, though, we saw the Sasquatch last night, right? She probably just went home.
Or hooked up.
Yeah.
So you find
that's what I said, Adam.
You find an area where there's some sort of obvious, I don't want to say altercation, but there's a great deal of trampling.
Scuffle.
There's some pronounced activity.
I will do a notice check on it.
All right.
To see if I notice.
If there was a scuffle?
Anything. And this time I'm gonna roll with my D6 instead of 2 D8s. Because that's what I rolled the first 4 times.
This game is called Savage Worlds.
Five. All right. So you really retrace the steps. It's obvious that two masters engaged in a sword fight here.
One went off in that direction, and the other one followed these tracks to Gilder.
The loser fought one off in that direction.
Yes.
It's obvious that this is where something happened. Roxanne, you find out a bandana Roxanne had been wearing. And
it's the size of a tarp.
we can use it as a shelter.
It's a tent. It's a moo-moo. But anyway, it's a pretty obvious trail to where she was dragged off.
I'm going to go follow that quickly, as fast as I can.
I'm going to follow not quite as fast as I can, but I'll follow.
It took you an hour to retrace your steps to there. So whatever's happened probably 45 minutes to an hour ago.
I'm going to hustle.
On.
You're going to hustle through?
Yeah.
I keep up with Coaches.
Everybody else keeping up?
I am turning and looking to make sure everybody in our group is together.
All right. So it is Texas. It is a hot day. So I'd like everybody to give me a...
Vigor.
Vigor check. I think Constitution. Please give me a vigor check.
This isn't even like a practice for me. Come on. This is like a day off.
She didn't sleep last night.
I rolled a 4.
You can have a +1 on your vigor check right now.
My vigor is the same as my notice. So
I have a 5.
Even though it says I'm looking around.
3?
I give you a +1.
All right.
I give everybody a +1 on it.
Perfect. So +1. That gets me up to a 3. Wanlow is tired. Does that give me a point of fatigue?
The next one will be
Edison really found that +1 useful. He got exactly a 4 with the +1.
Chris had rolling D6 +1. Okay, so Chris got a 3 +1 more. Was that +1 the one
I
gave?
Yeah, that's with the plus and then my. Yes.
Okay, but then you rolled your alibi for another 3. +1 gives you the 4, so you're good.
Correct.
All right.
Good.
So everybody is okay except for Wanlow. He seems a little winded from the...
I have the fatigue in my character sheet and it will auto-calculate on my rolls.
He's still at my beating heart.
That is awesome, Adam. That's very impressive.
Bob's so going to have a character sheet by next session.
I will send him the macros I've created.
You can bring your Kindle, Bob. That's all Adam's doing. He's got his new tablet there. And...
I love it. Right now, I am... switching apps, going to the D&D website, and then rolling 1d6, and then coming back, switching apps, and coming back to Hangouts. So you are so much more advanced than I am right now.
I just have dice.
Me too, Jeff.
Yeah.
Mikey 3.
Losers!
Sorry. God, what a sad concept, Jeff. We just have regular dice.
Kids in your analog, you old men in your analog world.
You in your physical world.
All right, so Coach East, Johnny Newton, follows the trail a little further in. Mm. Don't mix those two. He's got cooties.
Yeah, don't touch the rim either.
And another half hour through, and you find another one of the abandoned sawmills.
While we're tracking...
it leads out into an open area, and there's a sawmill. And you actually hear what sounds like the blade might be running. And, you know, you don't hear a lot of noise because there's not a motor. It's running off a wheel. It's running off a water wheel. Pulleys and such.
Pulleys.
Do y'all hear that? It's not just me.
I hear a squeaking noise.
What's where? Yeah, you can hear the pulleys kind of running. That kind of stuff.
Would a water wheel be able to generate enough torque to really get that to cut through a...
That's how they all ran back then.
I don't know. I wasn't there.
You weren't there. Did I get a good picture? I looked for a picture of an old-fashioned... bless you.
Right.
Of an old-fashioned...
Coming on down a three-part harmony.
One, of an old-fashioned lumber mill, I couldn't find one.
Oh.
Now with all, like, five guys standing in front of it. So.
Five ghosts.
Per ghost.
So, you obviously, like I said, you're there. You see, you hear the thing running. It's a pretty open area. It's a pretty dilapidated building. And you hear a scream. And it's
from
inside the building. And it's you know, you can kind of guess it's Roxanne.
I rush forward. I am loyal.
I follow
Are
this
foolish?
Dumbass.
No matter what they look like.
Wait, guys. What if Roxanne is causing the bad guys to scream? Have we considered that possibility?
Is she screaming in joy?
She's met up with a Sasquatch. What?
No. What we don't realize is that's her brother and her cousin.
Like I said, she just went home.
Family reunion. All right.
Chris is just rolling for fun now. All right. So
I'm trying to figure out how to get that D6 roll with it.
Slash roll 1D6 exclamation point.
Missing the exclamation point, Chris.
That makes it allows it to explode.
Oh,
I hustle in.
You hustle up to the building.
Carefully as I can, but still moving quickly.
Sure. I mean, there is a stream running the water wheel, so it's not like your running is too loud. Anybody else running up with him besides Wanlo? Is Anthony is chasing up behind you? He's got his camera going now. He's thinking, I'm going to get something awesome.
So he's filming the Blair Witch, right?
Yes.
Oh, jam the wheel.
Let's see what's going on first. Let's see what happened first.
It would be very hard to jam a water wheel. So, all right.
I got some rocks.
Did anybody else run off there with them?
I know there's nobody
forward
tonight.
Yeah, I'm going to take a more cautious approach.
All right.
Dennison is going with Johnny Moon.
That's just what we need.
I stepped away.
Wiggly Magoo.
It hurts when Mikey's camera doesn't quite focus on him. Like, I only get part of his face sometimes, and it's this way.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm just leaning back.
Oh, there he is.
I was just leaning back in my chair.
Okay. What's Joe Diffie up to?
Joe's going to kind of just keep an eye on everybody. I know Edison and Johnny Moon are kind of walking up ahead, so he's just going to...
So you're playing sniper.
Be their backup.
Or the evil cowardly wizard.
Or something like that, yeah.
All right, so you get up to the building. You peek in. You know, it's rotted out. There's timbers that are open.
I peek in.
All right, so let's move you guys to the right.
Do I have to do a look check?
No.
Do you notice anything when you put your eye on the people? Nope, I don't notice that big thing in front of me that's attacking Roxanne.
So, you look inside and you see the giant saw running.
Running?
Was cutting anything?
We just need to cut the blade. I would cut the...
Okay.
Belt.
Cut me some slack here, because I really didn't have a good option for this, but... And there's Roxanne, tied to a log.
Roxanne looks pretty good.
Never looks so good.
For those
Wait,
other...
Where's the felon with the mustache curled up?
I want to know where's Underdog when you need him.
So if anybody's actually listening to this, it's a cartoon picture. It could be Underdog or one of those. It's a cartoony picture. It's a woman tied to a log getting ready to run into the sawmill. Classic thing that we grew up with, except for Adam was the baby.
Nah, I saw this stuff too. I had the USA Cartoon Express as a kid. That showed the same cartoons you watched growing up.
And then...
Now it shows like Batman, the Brave and the Bold.
Yes. And then, just for fun, walking in front of your vantage point, you see...
I wouldn't be just...
That thing's got to be 6 feet tall without the head attached. It is the biggest, one of the biggest men you've ever seen.
Guys, he might be...
I know guys who are 6 feet tall with no head. I'm in the room with two of them.
A 5'10".
No.
He might be holding...
Your head's not that big.
Big Boy Jim's hook. Oh, wait, that's him? Okay.
You know what they say, the bigger they are, the more they can kick your ass.
So, if anybody has ever seen this, is the picture of Bloody Jim from the ETU book.
I was wondering about that, because that's pretty spot on.
It's a well-built man carrying his head in his left hand, wearing overalls and a giant hook in his right hand.
Hey, guys, he can only attack with one hand.
Watch out for a righty. I don't know, is that what you...
Hey, why don't we ask him a question?
Initiative?
See if he can raise his hand.
We haven't figured out initiative in the app yet, huh?
Tell him a funny joke.
Yeah, but there's a lot of effort to set me up. I have to add everybody.
Yeah. I only found two of my Oh, there's my third Benny.
So Roxanne he puts the head down as you're watching.
What is she wearing?
He puts the head down on a shelf.
Do we need to?
Her jeans and a sweatshirt. He puts the head down on a shelf and finishes tying her to the log. Puts the hook in the log, drags it onto the conveyor, and the log starts getting pulled down toward the saw blade.
What runs the conveyor? Can we tell?
There's a series of pulleys inside, hooked up to the water wheel outside.
Okay. So it seems as though the conveyor and the wheel are both part of the same apparatus.
Yes, there's only one driving mechanism, that would be the water wheel. You have 4 rounds to stop Roxanne's death. You like combat with a goal.
And what is the benefit? I'm Code Bonner Law.
I don't have those hindrances.
That thing is spinning so fast, somebody can lose an arm in there really easily.
Okay, so we have Adam. Ooh, or Bob. Oh, God. Jeff. Chris. Oh. Mike. Jim. Okay. Oh,
one more for me, please.
And one more. Oh. So the good news is, so we've got a 3, a jack, a king, and a 10 for the PCs. A 2 for, I assume, Bloody Jim. And then a 9 for
his head.
So we start with Chris.
Hey.
On deck is Jeff.
Thank you for on deck.
It's not going to matter. It's Jeff.
All right, Chris, you're up.
Can I just look around?
Well, I mean, you've seen what there is to see in there. It's a pretty good-sized room.
Yeah.
It's probably about 30 feet long. It's designed for the logs to come in on the right-hand side, and then they come through, and they get sawed up. Lumber goes out the other side. You're almost even with the actual blade where you're looking in, so you're kind of mid-structure looking in. And,
okay.
You know, there's various benches and tables in there and stuff for handling lumber and sorting it. There's this series of pulleys and what's what I'm looking for? It's not rope. It's more like a belt that runs it.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, these things were freewheel, so even if you cut the belt, that blade's going to keep spinning.
For a while, at least.
Oh, yeah. Quite a while.
But the belt, if we cut the belt, it should stop the conveyor from going.
Well, once it gets under a load, it'll stop.
Depends on which belt you cut.
Yes.
Once it gets under a load, it'll stop.
Yeah, so once it's halfway through Roxanne's head, it'll stop.
As long as the...
Yeah, once it hits the wood, it'll stop. Because it's got no power anymore.
It's slightly ahead of... Ahead, no pun intended.
Where in location are we located between Bloody Jack?
I can't believe we don't have a picture of this. This is crazy.
Is he right in between us? Is he on
the between
side?
Us, are you crazy?
Bloody Jim is on the far side of the blade. So there's
that's
you,
the, bike did.
The wall, some empty space, the blade conveyor, and Jim's on the opposite side.
All right, I'm going to run next to the, or get next to the wood with my cleaver and my hatchet. I think I got the cleaver in my hand.
Well, you
got
to get in the building.
Oh, I thought we were in the building seeing this. Okay.
You were looking in through some of the shrunken, broken, you know, siding, for lack of a better term. So, otherwise Jim would have noticed you. Otherwise, now he's just going about his business, disposing of Roxanne.
Conveniently for us.
Anybody else have any?
All right.
I'm gonna run and make as much noise as I can to the farthest end, so Bloody Jim sees me all the way to the farthest end. All
right.
Causing a distraction, possibly for the rest of the people.
Sorry, don't mind me.
All right, so
go ahead and laugh, people.
So Ford Prefect runs down, bang on the wall. I want to see air screaming. I want to be an Air Force Ranger.
Yeah, yes. I'm not too young for that joke.
Air Ranger.
Whatever it is. It
doesn't matter.
Wait.
I just quoted Breakfast Club.
Wait a second. Right. I made sure I told the guys what I was doing.
So, Buddy Jim obviously takes notice of that. You're at the far end of the building. I should add, there are several places, if you made any effort, you can break through the wall. I mean, the stuff is that tired and rotten after 100 years out there. So.
Don't knock me.
We could knock the whole thing down.
No, there's big beams still up there. So Bloody Jim has been distracted. He's looking toward you, going to retrieve his head so he can come after you.
Aw, oh, damn.
All right, anything else, Chris? Are you good?
No, I'm good.
Who's next?
Me.
Jeff is.
I look for a weak spot.
Mike,
is there a weak spot near me?
Mike, you're on deck.
So I can get through?
You can break through.
I break through and I rush towards the head. I'm looking on the ground for anything that I can pick up and chuck as hard as I can at the head. Rocks, pieces of wood, blocks, pieces of scrap metal.
Bits of sawtooth, saw blade tooth.
Saw blade teeth.
You actually
I could frisbee a smaller
a small blade. Yeah.
The saw blade is like 3 feet in diameter.
But if they have any small ones, like, did you ever see Commando? When he's hiding in the tool shed.
Yeah, that was a circular saw blade.
Yeah,
they didn't have
circular
saws back when they.
I think so. That's what they killed. I killed you last. The sweat matrix. You did.
Ironically, you actually see another hook on the floor. The handle's rotted out, so it's just the hook itself.
I'm going to take that hook, and I'm going to throw it at the head.
So, throwing.
That is a throwing skill.
Even though I'm a quarterback, I'm a
D4. I thought you were a cornerback.
I was a quarterback in high school.
Okay.
All right. Let me roll those two dice again.
Oh, boy. Two bennies already, huh?
No explosion.
Oh.
Dual explosion.
Explosion.
Ten. So he has a parry of six.
No. Well, if it's thrown, it should just be against
him. Yeah, it's a target. Yeah, so you hit the hit.
So you got a raise.
Hit with a raise. It's a D4 for an improvised weapon plus your strength.
D6. Seven.
Does the head have a separate toughness?
He has a toughness of six, so he is shaken.
He's shaken. The head just went. I just don't.
Where is it sticking into right now? Did I just pierce its ear? Is it like through an eye hole?
You've given it a giant earring now.
So is
the
body...
blunt, the blunt end of the hook hit the side of the head, knocking it off the shelf.
All
right. Okay. So that was your turn. Mike, you're up next with a one of the bad guys up next.
Or second it could be that next. Could be
that could be reinforcements.
No, what's her name up next?
Roxanne?
Yeah.
Or it could be the guy, the cameraman.
The cameraman is all about the camera right now.
What do you mean?
Mike, you're up. Joe Diffie, right. He was further away, so he just saw you guys enter the building. There's not anything that's going on.
And except, that does he know that you know something else? Something hit him in the face.
But I don't think Mike has actually seen Bloody Jim because he said he was bringing up the rear, back.
Yeah. Okay.
So you saw Chris run. You saw Ford run off, making a ton of noise toward one of the building.
Well, Ford did say, "I'm going to distract him."
Right, and then you saw Cochise enter, and you heard a couple of loud thumps.
I mean, I would imagine I could hear the saw running.
Yes.
Okay. So I'm making my way up to where those guys went in.
Okay.
And upon immediately seeing Roxanne strapped to the log, I pull out my pistol and think it's best to put her out of her misery.
No! Save her!
Oh, no, I'm sorry. Wait. Wrong idea. Upon seeing Bloody Jim, I immediately think it's best to put him out of his misery. I got confused as to which one I was supposed to shoot.
Shoot for the smaller one.
Yeah.
The 7-foot monstrosity of a man? Or anyway.
Roxanne's a much bigger target. I mean, my likelihood of missing is like got to be in the negative.
It's 7 foot tall or 7 foot wide.
Yeah.
So I'm assuming you're shooting the body of Jim since the head is on the ground on the other side of the salt lake.
All right. Well, the head's on the ground, so I would imagine I don't see the head.
Correct.
So okay.
You can aim for the body, though.
Okay. So the body's living without the head attached to it. Okay,
you know,
awesome.
In retrospect, Jeff should have been a called shot.
Too late.
Yeah.
So I've got a conundrum in my mind as I'm walking in and I'm absorbing the sight of Roxanne strapped to a log, trying to figure out which one's bigger.
don't lie. You're all excited about seeing Roxanne tied down.
No. No.
Yeah. No.
Really.
I'm trying to keep my breakfast
Hulk
down.
Smash.
As I'm absorbing the visual of Roxanne strapped to a log heading towards the sawmill. And
all I can think is, that's a lot of rope.
Rethinking all of my childhood cartoon memories.
That's a big water.
As I look up, I see the body of what I would assume is Big Bloody Jim, because it's got no head attached to it.
Correct.
I quickly look back to the saw machine, and is there something that I see that if I think I can shoot it, it would stop the machine from spinning the blade?
Notice that.
I don't think so. I mean, you know, it's a heavy mechanism.
Oh, no, I agree. I mean, I'm pretending like I don't know actually how these things work.
Yeah. You're welcome to pull off a shot, but you're going to have to roll pretty darn good to make any kind of impact.
Okay. So I'm going to attempt. So is Roxanne just tied to the log?
Looking at Roxanne tied up. I threw up in my mouth a little. she straps a log in with multiple ropes, so it's not like you're not going to cut her off in one turn.
Oh.
No. I realize that. There's a lot of her to tie down, so I wouldn't imagine that. Even if it was only one rope, it would still take a lot of cuts. Okay, so I was running up to the door, I draw my pistol. When I get the visual of Big Bloody Jim's body, I attempt to aim. Well, I guess you can't really aim, but I attempt to shoot center mass.
You attempt to shoot what?
Center mass.
He's okay. Just shooting at it.
Shoot the body.
Yep, shoot the body. Because there is no head to aim at.
All right.
Okay. Shooting. Okay, 5.
So that is a hit.
That's a hit.
Target number and target 7-4. So damage.
So my damage is this. 8.
8. All right. So bullet enters in just in the big shoulder area. The body takes a jerks back, and it appears as if he's wounded.
Is that the end of Mike's turn?
That's the end of Mike's turn.
Your second card.
My second card is going to it's gonna be Jim in this case, because the other card won't come into play until later.
There's two Jims.
The head and body are acting as one on this turn.
Okay, gotcha.
Okay.
So he was already wounded?
Yeah, he was shaken.
He was shaken, and now he's
wounded. Taking a wound.
That's a big toughness. Six?
Mm.
Somewhere around there.
Yeah. So I need to make a...
Shaken.
Spirit would be shaken. I should try to soak the wound first.
Oh, you're going to spend a bending to soak the wound.
I'm going to try to soak the wound.
That's vigor.
That's a vigor.
You have four or better.
Four.
So he is soaked the wound, and I believe he's no longer shaken.
No wound's not shaken anymore?
That's kind of what we read, but that was assuming you took a wound and shaken at the same time. We did say if you the quick version was, if you soak all of your wounds, you are no longer shaken.
Right. All right. So he walks over. He picks up the head.
Damn.
He doesn't put it on top.
No, he's got it in one arm.
He turns towards you with the head under his arm, and the head puts on this sickly grin. And the most remember how the teddy bears were kind of disturbing? Random pieces of lumber throughout the building stand up and animate.
What?
Come to life, ready to attack.
Oh, God.
Oh, it was so nice knowing Roxanne.
All right.
There are six by your count.
Bob, you're up.
What came to life? Six what? I'm sorry?
Six pieces of lumber, metal spikes, all kinds of things just kind of coalesced, sawdust coalesced into six, for lack of a better term, stick men.
So it's six lumber
dolls. Imagine a 2x4 stick.
Yeah, it's 6 foot dolls.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Got it. Guys, he's a lumberjack. He's okay.
He's up all night and he works all day?
You've been saving that one?
Edison thinks quickly, and he only has a pocket knife to his name, so he races over to the damsel in distress, although damsel is questionable, and he begins hacking away at the ropes that are tying Roxanne to the log.
All right. I'm going to say there's four ropes tying her down. And I'm going to give you an automatic hit, but I need a damage roll on it. And each rope will have X amount of toughness.
Okay, gotcha. So that would be a fighting check?
So I'm going to call it an automatic hit. So strength plus weapon. So it's a D4 plus your strength.
Which is a D4.
Okay, and my strength is D4 as well. Let me go to the other window, and I'll roll two D4s. And actually... maybe I can have a proxy roller. Adam, if you wouldn't mind, could you roll 2d4s for me?
Sure.
My whole phone crashed, so I have to go back out to the website. It'll just take too long.
Yeah, I can do that for you.
Do you want actual dice, Adam?
No, fuck that noise.
Is that typing in there?
It's because your computer is slow.
Well, we knew that. Has it typed yet?
It typed the slash. Maybe I can do it from my... Oh.
Wow, it's really slow.
D4 exclamation point. Oh, you got 11!
You exploded on both D4s. So Edison having...
I think I killed that rope. Ha
ha! The two of them... Bing, bing!
So Edison being Edison has diligently kept the knife sharp. He jumps up there, unfolds it, goes right to work, and he looks like Vincini cutting the rope for when the man in black is climbing the cliffs of insanity. He cuts through. That rope is like 3 inches thick, and he cuts through it like it's butter.
Butter,
baby. First rope is off of Roxanne.
All right.
Oh, my God. Edison, she looks to you, and it's like, oh, my savior.
One blow is up next, Mule. is there anything...
Just do my job, Roxanne. Are you okay?
She's screaming hysterically.
Is there anything that looks as though it will interfere with Edison trying to cut the rope?
Yeah, there's two that are near the... very near the saw. And maybe a couple more scattered throughout. There's four, there's six total. All
right, I will attack one that is very near Edison.
Okay.
To try and allow him to continue to cut the rope.
I'll...
That karate chop. Oh, damn it. I changed that.
You trying to break the board?
What's its parry?
You trying to break the board?
Break the board. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Parry of five.
All right, so apparently I missed. Hopefully it will attack me next round, because I'm really just a diversion at this point.
So Wanlo runs up there, attempts to split the board with his karate chop.
Oh, you said, and that was with a it would have had a five if I wasn't fatigued.
Oof.
But my fatigue is over now, right? You said it was just the next roll?
Okay, yeah.
I'm asking, I don't know.
Yeah, that's fine. So, Wanlo karate chops it, and you hear the board crack, but it doesn't quite give way.
All right.
Next up?
Next up is the boards, I believe. It's your first
one. They don't get enough. They don't get an action.
I'm sorry, I just want to clarify. We have a Kung Fu Karate Master who's being attacked by animated boards. This is your wheelhouse. I can't believe it. If you didn't kill it.
This is totally racist, is what it is.
I feel like you should. Aren't you like a black belt? Shouldn't six of these guys line up and then you can hit them once and then break them all in half at the same time?
Stack them all up.
Something like that. All right.
Okay, just checking.
Adam with a nine of hearts. Bob with a deuce of diamonds.
Ouch.
Jeff with a queen of spades. Chris with a six of hearts. Mike with a five of hearts. Josh gets a four of spades and a seven of hearts. So first we have Jeff. Everybody goes before the creatures except for Bob. So Jeff first, then me.
No, I have a seven.
Yeah, I know how to count.
So Chris has a six.
Yeah, I Mike really fucked that up big time. Wishful thinking, okay?
I take my knife out and I run over towards Roxanne. And I go to attempt to cut the ropes and try to pull her off.
All right,
so maybe push her off.
Can you push somebody the whole log over?
Pull her over. I don't want to get hurt.
All right, so you're trying to cut a rope.
My rope cutting skill...
Is it D4 plus strength?
Yeah, it's just damage. It's melee damage.
Rope has a toughness of 6.
I rolled a 7 total. Does that mean I have to, like... I don't have to roll anything.
You're just rolling damage at this point. You cut.
I don't miss the...
Johnny's wound cuts through the second rope.
So I'm up next. I will try and attack a board again. I will... You said there was two near. I'm going to attack the other one. Okay. Try and draw both their attention.
Just to...
Rolling 1D, stupid. So that's Chris
Just as a thought, if I would give you an opposed strength check if you tried to push one into the saw. That is an awesome coolness part there.
I will try and grab a board and toss it into the saw.
Woo-hoo. I think you would pick it up by one end and swing it.
That could be too.
So it is an opposed strength check.
Alright, my strength is a D6.
I hope that saw is not that strong. I rolled a one.
Hopefully I can beat this.
What?
It's exploding seven.
Wanlo, what happens?
So Wanlo, okay, so one of the golems, the other golem, seeing Wanlo engage with the first wood golem, tries to attack him. But Wanlo grabs him by the, you know, blocks the attack, grabs the arm, and uses his momentum to swing him into the saw. So it's kind of like a judo move. Where he uses the momentum against him and flips him into the saw.
I see. This one happens to have no metal bits to explode all over.
Well, that's good.
It explodes into splinters and sawdust. And, you know, I mean, at the end of the day, it's still tired old wood. Once it's unanimated, it just
crumples.
Yeah. Explodes into sawdust everywhere.
Nice.
Hey, Wanlo! Edison looks up. He was bored to death.
Oh, God.
See, because he's wooden board, and now he's dead. Oh, never mind.
I'm sure that Roxanne will love your ability to laugh in the face of danger.
All right, who's next?
Next is your second card, which is what you did with Bloody Jim.
So I got one, two, three, four.
I don't know why you guys aren't showing up here. That makes me upset.
All right, so Bloody Jim focuses on Wallow since he's already destroyed one of his creatures.
Well, let me look at my parry on my tablet, on my online character sheet.
He stalks over with his giant hook, takes a big swing at Wallow.
How big of a swing?
I get a wild die for him.
Ooh. Roll low on both of them, then.
So fighting is just versus your parry.
Yes.
What's your parry?
What's your fighting?
My fighting was a D8, but I rolled a 5.
Oh, it's a hit. Oh, wait. Is there anybody adjacent to me?
Yeah.
I should be close to you.
There's like three of us.
No friendlies are adjacent to me? My Be a Zebra doesn't come into play?
No, I don't think so.
I should be close to you because I was at the...
Wait a minute. Aren't you next to Edison?
Well, I mean, he's not engaged in combat.
Yeah, so. They're not. They're totally different actions.
Yeah.
So.
I try to cut down...
Strike.
If she's... I don't know.
All right.
Well, roll low on this one, will you?
7.
That's not low enough. I am shaken.
The giant hook swings by. It's dull. And so it's
swinging, and it goes between the gap between my neck and my chest, just barely missing my throat.
Actually, I was going to be nice to do that, but okay.
Making me stumble backwards and come off balance.
Sure.
So I'm now shaken.
Yes. The point doesn't hurt you. The point doesn't
get
you.
It doesn't actually make contact, but it's enough to throw me off.
Yeah. Your motion gets more the fist part than the hook part.
All I could think of at that moment was I was challenged to channel Ekarath. I interrupt that.
No, that was Mara. Mara.
That was Mara. you swear you might have heard a rib crack. That's like, you know, when you're martial arts classes, this you don't get hit like this in martial arts classes. This guy hits you like a load of bricks.
Yeah. Not enough to damage me, but enough to make me stumble.
Yes. All right. Big Jim's turn is up. Next up.
Oh, after Big Jim, sorry, we have Chris. After Chris is Mike.
All right, Mr. Reporter Guy.
I'm just going to take some notes.
Takes out his cell phone.
Right now. Very interesting. No, I'm going to take the cleaver and go try to chop out our lovely lady.
All right, so you're going to go over there and...
Wait, when did we get a lovely lady here?
Oh, ba-dum-ba.
I've grown fond of her, like a fungus,
like a wart. All right, so
like a bad rash.
All right, to get to her, you have to run past two of the. I'm going to stick with wood golem for a better term. Two of the wood creatures.
So I'm going to have to. They're going to get a free swing.
At least one will. Hmm.
All
right. I can't make it too easy for you guys.
Ah, hell, I'm going to live edge, man. I'm doing it. All right, what do I need to roll?
You're going to try swinging one of the wood guys? So you need your fighting skill.
I'm just going to run by him.
Oh, you're going to run by him?
Yeah, fighting. Excellent. I'm going to give you a free attack.
All right. Well, there's two of them. So they are going to... You rush by. What is your parry?
32.
It's more like 4, 5, or 6.
4.
Mike's parry.
4, all right. So I rolled a 4. So is that a hit or miss?
If it's a tie, it's a hit.
It's a hit.
Because tie goes to the runner, even though we have no idea what that means.
Yes. All right. Shooting, not shooting. It's a strength damage, so... Stupid 1. So one swings at you... You dodge it. The other one hits you from behind, pushes you along, but doesn't hurt you.
Nice.
You make it to Roxanne.
All right, you make it to Roxanne. So I sit and discuss with her how she's doing. All
right, now you need a D4 plus your strength check to cut through the rope.
D4 plus my strength. All right. Hold on. Where the hell did it go? Damn it, I'm trying to do all fancy and bags on me. All right, never mind. I got one of those dice here. There it is. Plus my strength.
D4 plus strength.
Yeah, I got a 3, and my strength is a 6, 9.
All right, so you cut through that second to last. There's one last rope left. The saw is still about a foot away. So.
And we have Mike up next, and then the wood golems after Mike.
All right, Joe Diffie. Joe Diffie, you had made it to Roxanne last turn, right? And cut one of the ropes loose.
I did not cut Roxanne's ropes loose.
Okay.
I shot the body of.
That's right, Bloody Jim.
The Bloody Jim. So I'm assuming now that Bloody Jim is attacked one low, he's closer to us.
Yep. He's melee range.
So if you attack Bloody Jim, you will get a gang up bonus of a plus one to him.
Huh? Well, coincidentally, that's what I was
that's
thinking.
True. That's in melee. That's melee, not
right.
Not,
so you,
not
so you're melee. Time. So you're not the pistol is a negative in melee.
Yeah, no, I totally understand.
No, it's
right?
That the target number is parry.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Four.
Okay.
It's essentially negative. Assuming as parry
yep.
is more than four.
So I mean, it hasn't been that long since we've been out of D&D. I got it.
And now I'm explaining for Josh.
So you shooting Jim? Or you? What are you doing?
No, I am pulling out my knife and I'm going to stab Jim in the head.
Oh.
That he's holding.
A called attack? Called shot?
Called shot to the head is minus four.
Yeah, why not? I'm plus one, so minus one makes it all good.
No, called shot is minus four. Called shot to the head is minus four. Called shot anywhere else is minus two.
Mike, here's a thought too. If you went with a wild attack, I think that gives you plus two hit and damage. With your plus one, with a flanking bonus or grouped attack, that would give you a net of plus three to hit. And then if you take the minus four from the called shot, it would be a net minus one with plus two damage.
It does leave you with a parry of two for that turn, though.
Minus two, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. It lowers your defenses for the rest of that turn, though, too. So there's a downside.
And, the likelihood is, if he attacks me, unless he rolls a one, he's probably hitting me. So.
And the boards, though, the wood golems still have to go.
Hmm. No, go ahead, Bob.
Just a reminder, too, that What's-Her-Face is about a foot away from going James Bond style. No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to die.
In this case, that's... Never mind.
You guys are so mean to poor Roxanne.
Totally. We're horrible.
Save her life.
So, you know what? There's three other people around Roxanne that cut her loose. I'm going after Jim.
We got two rounds.
Yeah. We still got two rounds and three guys there.
That's a good point. All right.
So I am going to attempt to stab Jim in the head with my knife.
All right, so is it minus four? Right. Are you making a wild attack?
With a wild attack.
So it's a plus two for that, and we're going to give you plus one for a gang up bonus. You have a net minus one on your attack roll.
Okay.
So this would be a fighting roll against Jim's parry, and you have a minus one.
Okay, so I rolled a one on one dice, and I exploded on the other, so that's a six, and 10 total.
All right, so Jim's parry of six is inadequate. You jab your knife in.
Oh, wait, sorry. Minus one would have been a nine.
Yes, fine.
And there's a plus to damage when you do a called shot to the head as well.
I think it's a plus four to damage.
I think it's a plus four to damage.
Yeah, agreed. So plus four on the called shot and then plus two from the wild. Yeah. So he's at a static plus six.
Plus the D4 for the knife in the air and plus your strength.
D4 plus strength. So let's see.
It's like we know the rules.
I know, right? Like, I'm actually getting ready to look this up, and I'm wondering why.
Because we already know.
Oh, it's because I can't.
So I have six plus my strength is a 6. That's a 12. And I rolled a 3, so 15 total points of damage for stabbing Jim in the head.
I think the zombie campaign helped us with the cold shots, though, definitely.
Yeah, right? No kidding.
So, okay, so Jim has a toughness of 6.
And Mike got a 12?
15.
15.
So 6 is shaken.
4 10, more is 10.
11, 12, 13, 14. So he's shaken with 2 wounds.
Right, so I'm going to try to soak some of that. There's a D8.
If you get an 8 or better, you've soaked all the wounds and are not shaken.
I have not successfully shaken anything.
You can roll again. Josh rolls again.
Wow, I'm using my bennies. I made a success. I have 1-4, so I have 1 down to 1 wound.
You have 1 wound and you're still shaken.
Guys, I have to step away for a little bit. Adam, could you be my proxy in the meantime?
Sure.
Thank you, sir.
Where's he going?
Do something cool. We just pulled into the driveway, so now I got to bring in luggage and stuff like that.
Oh, you're home.
Wow. Did he get from the border to Milford
that
left fast?
What?
Were you on 84?
Andrea was moving.
Wow. Dang. I don't want to do that. I couldn't do it that fast. And I've ridden with Adam. It's scary.
She was driving that fast because she didn't want to hear this anymore.
I buy that.
I've got headphones on. I don't think she's heard anything, but maybe she was driving that fast because she doesn't want to hear my side of it talking.
That could be it.
Sorry, Andrea.
Tell Andrea you love her. We appreciate her patience. All right. So whose turn is it now?
It is the wood golems.
Okay, so there are 5 wood golems left. They converge on the group of you, which you've nicely clustered around the saw.
Oh, man. Well, they have to choose who they're attacking for gang-up bonus purposes.
Since they are mindless creatures, they will randomly attack. All right, 2 on Cochise. 1 on 4rd. 1 on Edison. 1 on Joe Diffie. Somehow Wanlo didn't get hit.
Because I'm good like that.
Because you're good like that? So, alright. Fighting skill is a
2. 2 to fighting, attack, and damage, but parry is reduced by 2. Nice.
Alright, so the 2 that attack Cochise.
2 of them, come on. Missing both. Good. Next.
One of them gets a +1 to hit.
Right. So it's a 4 on my fighting. What's your parry?
Guess if it's a 5.
5.
So Kochi somehow dodges both attacks.
Super.
Next up would be Ford. That's a 5. I believe that's a hit, Ford.
That is a hit.
Yeah, -4, +4 on called shots. Dang, we're good.
All right, so Ford takes 10 damage.
Whoa.
This thing hauls off and belts Ford.
It doesn't like me too much.
Splintered him.
It crashes into him, causing him to smash into one of the posts that's holding the building up, head first. So, Ford, what is your toughness?
Oh, I got a 5 toughness. So that's 1 wound.
So it's shaken and a wound.
Yeah.
So.
You want to soak that? Try to soak that?
I recommend you soak that.
Yeah, I'm going to try to soak it. So what do I have to do?
So you give you toss one of your invisible bennies to me. Thank you. Put that away.
So that's what tossing something through the internet sounds like.
Exactly. Now you roll your vigor for the wolves.
My vigor. +6, right? Both of them?
Yes, plus your wild die.
All right, here we go. I got a 5.
That soaks it.
So that soaks the wound. You're no longer shaken or injured.
It's like it never happened.
Never happened.
Except I took one of your bennies away. Your all precious Benny.
Thank God I have my helmet on.
Precious.
All right, next up is Edison. Edison's sheet is there, Adam.
Yes.
So you have some reference. Oh, another 6 to hit.
I'm pretty sure that hits Edison.
8.
Did Edison get hit twice?
Is that hit with a raise?
His parry is a 4. It is a hit with a raise. You roll an additional d6 damage.
That stinks. He's going to come back dead.
You're dead. I roll a 1 and a 3.
Oh, my goodness.
4 damage to Edison.
Oh.
Doesn't do anything, does it?
4 damage to Edison. His toughness is a 5.
So he, Edison, somehow
he is the luckiest bastard.
There's like how many in a row?
He perfectly angles his body so that the blows have minimal impact.
Yeah, right.
All right, Joe Diffie, last one of you. Another 6. 9. What is your parrying weight?
It is a parry is a 5.
So that is a hit with a raise also.
With a raise.
7 damage to Joe Diffie. So I'm thinking that's probably shaken.
So my toughness is a 6.
It's shaken.
It is shaken. So on your turn, you get to roll against that.
Right.
Or you can spend a Benny to get rid of it at any time.
Yeah, but it's worth waiting for your turn, really.
Well, we'll see.
Yeah, yeah, I'm with Adam. I got you, Adam. I'm following you.
Yeah. So, all right.
So we have Adam with a 7, Bob with a 6, Jeff with a queen, Chris with a 10, Mike with a 5, the wood golems with the Joker, what's his name?
Bloody
Jim with a 4. So it's going to be wood golems, all of us, Bloody Jim.
There's 5 of you and 5 wood golems left?
I believe so.
All right. So you're each getting the wood golem attack. Just gonna, everybody gets one.
So Mike is shaken. So his if it just hits his parry, his toughness, he will take a wound.
Right. They are all wild attacking.
Oh, great.
Oh, no. They're going to attack twice.
Why do they attack twice?
Because they have +2. For every roll, they attack twice as -2, so it's gonna be 2 attacks against each of you.
But if they do that, they can't attack like they have to attack with a different weapon or a different hand, and they would get an offhand bonus, offhand penalty of an additional -2. So if you attack twice, it's -2 and -4. We screwed that up before.
Because it's like, all the wind out of my sails you just took.
Yeah, well, that you're welcome, everybody.
Do they get a bonus for being next to each other?
No, well, I had to distribute their attack, so there's no gang bonus, just to make it a little saner. So, all right, they'll just wild attack.
So +4 on all their attacks, because they have the Joker.
+4 on their attacks, +4 on their damage.
Oh, you're trying to kill us.
I'm bringing out the big guns.
Oh, baby.
All right, Johnny Boone. 5 plus is a 9. What's your parry?
5.
It's 2
with a raise.
2d6 plus 6.
No, plus d6.
It's a d6?
You get an additional d6 if you hit with a raise.
Right in a row. I have d6 damage.
Oh.
I have d6 bonus for that.
Oh, okay.
And then
plus
I get
4.
Plus 4 for the wild attack and the Joker.
Which one is this? Is this the big dude? Huh?
No, this is the...
11 damage.
Boards?
11 damage from the boards, yes.
11 damage. Just to see his face like...
I have a toughness of 5.
What do I do with that?
Yeah, right.
All right, 5.
9, that's a hit with a raise. You are wounded.
You have a wound. You want to try to soak it?
I'm going to try to soak it.
Give me a Benny. And roll your vigor.
8.
You soaked the shit.
Giant
out
Moon toughs it out.
Hey, I've been to football practice in Texas, okay?
Next up, Juan Lowe.
Piece of board scrapes.
You know, unless I roll a 1, it's a hit.
Yeah.
Pretty much everybody.
Maybe I'll roll a 1.
Or maybe I'll roll a 2.
Plus 6. 4 is 6, which is a hit against my parry.
Damn it. Ooh. 12. 16. Plus 4 is 20.
Oh!
Giant
Moon's dead. No, that's Juan Lowe. What's my toughness here?
Juan Lowe, go back.
Juan Lowe might be in trouble, guys.
How many bennies you got? Use them up.
Not enough. I really can't find my toughness because the sheet isn't on the way.
One more?
Yeah.
I'll buy you one more.
Thanks. You're so generous.
Alright, sorry, guys.
You for your toughness?
Yeah, it's probably a 5. And nobody's next to me for being a zebra? I guess it doesn't really matter. Oh, not looking for my toughness, looking for my parry. My parry is definitely
Parry's
a 5.
and parries.
I'm
a five.
Next to you.
And oh no, you rolled. That was damage. You rolled. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
I do have to look for my toughness.
I'm next to you. That
your toughness is a five. I have your sheet in front of me now too.
Oh.
20.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Well, it's only three wounds. Oh, shit.
And then we just crossed into unknown territory there.
Well, ooh, that wasn't good.
Wallow goes down like a load of bricks.
Well, let's see. He's going to soak.
You got to soak at least one or you're in deep trouble.
So right? It's the same as my notice. Come on, dice. I didn't even soak one.
0.75. Oops. You at least get it on the table.
Trying again.
Man of Wama. He's big. Adam's book hatches. Oh, another 0.75.
Jesus. All right, let me hit it again. This is my last Benny. Oh, the last one will count, not the first one, if I actually hit it twice.
All right. You have another one coming or not?
I'd say it looks like I soaked one, so I took two wounds.
So Juan Lowe is in dire straits, but not dead. I'm trying to look up death here, just in case we get to that point.
You take over Roxanne's.
Bopped up.
All right, so Juan Lowe is hurt pretty bad. Moving down the list, Chris. For Ford.
Here we go.
5 plus 4 is 9.
No,
your toughness is?
4.
No, I'm sorry, your parry.
4.
Your parry's a 4. That's a hit with a raise. It's an extra d6 plus 4. 10 damage. Your toughness, your toughness was 4
so
also?
Toughness is a 5, so I'm shaking with a wound.
Shaking with a wound. Did you want to try to soak this one?
Yep, Benny it.
Benny, all right, Chris has one Benny left.
Two, because I have luck.
You all have luck.
I don't have luck. I'm out of Bennies.
Do I need to roll for that, too, a soak, right?
You do.
And that's my vigor, right?
Yep. And your wild die.
I got a 5.
You got a 5. Okay, so you soak the one. You're free and clear. Next up is Edison. Edison, I hit with a 7.
Let's see. Edison's parry is a 4. So it's just a hit.
I roll 1 plus 4. He is the luckiest son of a... So it's 5 damage to Edison.
His toughness is a 5, so Edison is shaken.
And lastly, Joe Diffie. Badass extraordinaire. I roll a 6, which should be a hit. 6 plus 2 plus 4 is 6. So your toughness is... Your parry is...
And the parry is a 5.
5, all right. So damage will be a 6, 11, 15. Wow, I rolled some big damage. 15. So what's your toughness, Mikey?
No, this is just a fucking golem. Yes.
This is a 6.
6 is a 6. Adam, so you had a 6. I rolled 15 damage. So 10, so that's 2 wounds.
Yeah, 2 wounds.
You want to soak that, buddy? Or try it?
No, I'm just going to die.
Awesome. No, yeah, you like playing Joe Diffie too much.
I've had enough of ETU. I want out. College isn't for me.
You're not dead. You just minus 2 for every roll.
I will be the next time one of those guys attacks me.
You do that in California for a couple years in a row?
I know, right?
So I'm going
like
to obviously try to soak that.
Years. They're able to like...
How do they know?
Wait, is it my turn? Can I just get,
You can soak right now. You throw a Benny on the table and you soak.
I don't need a Benny. I'll just wait for my turn.
Next, by the way.
No. If you want to soak the wound, you got to do it now. It's only shaking that you can deal with on your turn.
Yep.
All right, so then I'll soak
the
wound.
Mike is shaking already, isn't he?
Yes.
So that's 3 wounds.
That's 3 wounds. Now you really want to roll high.
I exploded on both of them.
Keep going.
You only get the highest one.
Yeah, you only get the highest one.
Okay, so I exploded on another one. And a 4.
So the total 8. Is?
16.
16. So 4 gets you the 1. 8 gets you the next one. But yeah, you soak them all somehow. Somehow Joe Diffie is got his jacket of impenetrability on it. Or badass toughness, one of the two.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Apparently, that talking to my parents gave me before I left for college means I better stay here, otherwise I'm going to be living on out of the street. So.
And you're tough enough to do that, too. So, all right, so you managed to soak that wound. You are good to go. Jeff, who's up next over there, then?
I believe I am.
Oh. How have you got a face card every time?
I'm quick.
So every one of the
golems
is wild attacked, so they're minus 2 on their parry right now. They're also minus 2 for...
How many are out there?
I know, I think it's just parry.
How many are out there?
There's still 5 left.
I was going to go after the main guy and try to...
Whatever, man.
Jim has a wound.
Who does?
And Mike soaked all of his wounds, so he's no longer shaken.
Correct.
I believe I am next to the... saw because I
you're all
saved.
There. Yeah, you're all right around it.
Okay.
You want to try to push strength check and push him into the saw? That's where he died to begin with.
It would be apropos.
I think I'm going to go down to my 3-point stance.
You're quarterback. You don't go into 3-point stance.
I play in every position. Come on.
Posing strength checks. Posing strength checks.
Reverse cowgirl. Oh.
wait, who's next? Chris?
All of us. Yeah, you, then Chris, then me, then Bob, then Mike, then
I'm going to go, I'm not going to try to push him in. I'm just going to try to grapple with him and get him close. And I'm going to hope Chris is going to come in.
Or somebody else is going to come in and finish pushing him?
Yeah. I don't know what that
involves. It's the same chest.
Well, I mean, it's a... call that an agility trick? Just try to push him off balance?
Yeah, I guess you want to run your agility or strength.
But they're the same, I think.
We're going to call that an awesome check.
Why? Because it gives you a chance to be awesome?
Of course.
Do we have the cheat sheets around anywhere?
It's your choice then. Which one do you want to do?
Doesn't matter. I'm going to try to get him close to the blades.
Okay. So that's his as opposed to his agility. Ooh,
so that will give him a minus 2 to parry, and if you get a raise, it's a minus 2 to parry, plus he's shaken.
Wait, does he still get plus two for every roll?
No, that was the guy. No. That was the trees.
Oh, okay.
All right, so we're having a post agility check then. That's what, that works much better for you.
Okay.
How come that didn't sound like you'd rolled one dice?
My wild die exploded. 10.
I rolled a 4.
I rolled a 1 on my d4 for my agility, but my wild die came as a 6.
Does anybody have a dick card that makes him re-roll his...
Nope.
Okay. Cochise runs over there, tries to wrestle him toward it, and it looks like the Man in Black versus Andre the Giant.
I want you to feel you're doing well.
Hey, everybody else do that. He ain't going to roll that D4, D6,
I'm bleeding 10. Out, okay?
You don't care. It doesn't matter.
Who's next?
Chris.
I'm Chris. Inspired
go do the same
by
thing.
By the heroic... well, I'm not as huge as...
I got him off balance.
I'm going to do the same thing. He's off balance. He's stirred, not shaken.
Chris, whatever you just did, undo it, because we can barely hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Barely.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
That's better. All
right, I'm going to go ahead and rock him. I'm going to go ahead and try to knock him off.
All right, so are you trying to push him over or push him into the blade, which point is opposed strength, or are you trying to get him off balance, which is opposed agility, and somebody else will get a bonus when they try to push him in?
Yeah, agility.
Okay.
I mean,
so you're rolling your agility and your wild die.
Yeah. I explode and I get a 9. I get a 6 and a 3.
All right, so you Johnny Moon definitely got him off balance. You followed up with it because he only had 4. and he is completely off balance. So whoever tries a strength check against him will get a bonus, or he'll get a negative or something along those lines.
And by the way, I'm on one knee with my hands cupped together, ready to, you know, like somebody runs and they jump in and then they leap them over. I'm ready to do that.
Okay. Who's next?
Next up is me.
Oh, flying kick. Come on.
I had a minus two, though.
Yeah, I'm going to give you, like, plus four.
Okay, so, yeah, I'm going to... So if he's got his foot out, I'm going to try... I'm going to run and step to the best of my bleeding ability, step in Chris's hand and have him launch me foot first into his chest.
Ooh.
To try and knock it back.
Drop kick.
Kind of, but with one foot, because I'm like that, yo.
Because that's how I roll.
So this will be fighting, plus two.
Oh.
Yeah, those two wounds hurt.
Oh.
Of course, Soda's rolling two twos.
Two twos. Wallow jumps into Chris's fingers.
Steps right through.
Has no strength in the legs. You collapse into a pile of fleshy...
It looks like American Ninja Warrior when somebody mistimes to jump off a trampoline. Weep!
Oh, Bob has returned. So, Bob, to recap. The wood golems drew the Joker.
Oh, God.
They all wild attacked one person each.
And it's a good thing we're not attacking them.
Wanlow ended up with two wounds.
Oof.
He had actually gotten three. He soaked one. Joe Diffie took three, soaked all three.
Well done, Joe.
Somehow Edison got hit and took like three damage. Even he took five damage, and it was like a plus four.
Actually, did you add plus four to his roll? Did you roll against him?
Yeah, it's too late now.
Yeah.
So now the group has ganged up. Oh, you would have. Well, yeah, I gave you enough bonus there. Has ganged up, and they have Bloody Jim off balance over the saw blade, trying to push him into it.
Oh, that sounds very exciting.
Yes, I describe it much better than the die rolls.
Well, I don't know. If you give me a plus four, that's a five. What am I going against? Is Perry?
Well, you have minus two for your
That includes the minus two.
So you two plus two plus one is five minus two. Oh, you're each of those twos.
And it's taking the better of each of these, which are the same anyway.
Right. So two
plus one because I'm in the martial arts club. Minus two for my wounds.
Right. And I'll give you a plus one gang up bonus and plus two because he's off balance. So it's a four.
Plus two for gang up, plus one is a three, isn't it? Two
no, it's a five. Two. Three plus five.
You have one.
Yes.
I'm giving you plus one for the gang up.
That's a two.
I'm giving you plus two because he's off balance.
So that's a four. So that makes my attack roll a five. What am I attacking against?
How did you get five?
Four plus one is five, last I checked.
You have one. Yes. Start. That's your roll.
Plus one. Plus two is four. That's what I said. It's a four. I don't know why you keep trying to tell me it's a five. I've been saying all along it's a four.
So I will. Yeah, you're still.
Yeah, no.
You're still out of luck.
Wait a minute. I'm actually confused. If your roll, Adam, is a two plus a one minus two. Okay, so one of those die on the screen, that's your wild die, and the other one's your regular one? Is that how you got that set up to roll?
It takes the higher of the two.
It's the higher of the... Okay. All right. I'm just curious. I don't use that crap because it's too fucking stupid.
Oh, it is a pose. What do you know?
Adam, are you looking for one more? Are you trying to figure out a way to squeeze out one more?
All right.
What's that, Bob?
Too late. Looking to figure out a way to get it into a five? Because there might be a couple of bonuses you might have missed. But if not, never mind.
No, it's we're already past my turn. It's fine.
Okay.
All right, so who's left?
Bob, then Mike.
So Edison. So this is round two only. So there's still two more rounds before the lock is the thing. She has one rope still on her. Bloody Jim is off balance. Precariously over the saw blade. And it is... Edison's turn. At this point, either an agility or a strength check will push him into the blade. His agility's much poorer.
Well, so Edison has a D4 agility and a D4 strength. Fantastic.
You should probably just cut the rope.
I've seen the crossbow.
I guess. I mean, but how often are we getting the opportunity to have the hulking guy unbalanced? That's the thing, right?
Well, I go after you, so he's still unbalanced.
You have three bennies. Go for it, Bob.
And I have an agility of D8.
Wait, how many bennies does Edison have at this point? With three? Does he still have three wounds?
No.
Edison has no wounds. Did he soak one?
No, he didn't even get hit.
No. He didn't even get anything because
you're
you
right.
Rolled,
I think
rolled
I forgot the other four on there, but.
Oh yeah, but he had a monster hit roll, but you rolled like 2-2-1.
Yeah. So you have all your bennies still.
Or like 1-1-2, I think.
Wow.
Which should have been 8, but 2.
Okay, and Joe Diffie, do you have bennies still?
I have two bennies, yes.
I mean, you can delay Bob and let him go and then try afterwards if he fails.
Yeah, I think I'll delay. And
we're
we'll
trying
see
to
how
help
we'll
him.
There's already been one help. You.
All right.
Actually, Chris, you fail.
Yeah.
All right, Joe Diffie.
All right, so I'm going to attempt to take advantage of the situation while not stepping on Juan Lo. I'm going to use my agility and attempt to knock Big Bad Leroy Jim Brown off his feet and into the saw blade.
All right.
So my agility is D8 and D6, and we exploded on the D8 and rolled a 2 on the D8 and another 8 and.
He's going down now.
And a 1.
All right.
So 17.
All right. So obviously you've topped my roll before. Tell me what
just,
happened.
Just by a lot of it. I think you hit with a razor.
So
mic.
as I make my move, even Wang Lo is amazed at the deftness, swiftness
really.
In which I move around him, catching Jim unaware, getting one leg behind him while throwing an elbow into his chest and knocking him back into the saw blade, watching him splatter all over the place.
That was pretty gruesome and pretty awesome at the same time.
Yes, it was.
As Jim's guts splatter all over you and the walls
and
everything
Roxanne,
else.
Because she's right there all over her head.
Actually, it more goes the other way. But
oh, well, it depends on which way the blade is going.
Yeah.
Is it going up or down?
Down. So the five remaining wood golems collapse back into their parts of dust and metal bits and boards. The blade is still running, but all is quiet for the moment.
Except for the blade running, getting ready to saw Raxan's head.
Yes.
Guys, I really need help. Somebody, all of you help me, please.
Get me out of here! Save me!
Edison unties the slashes the last rope.
All right, you managed to get her out. Edison, if you want, and Edison or Johnny Miller, if you want to give me a quick check, you can. We'll see if you figure out how to disable the mechanism to turn the blade off. It's really just sliding a belt. Shouldn't be too hard.
I while they're doing that, I find Big Jim's hook and I grab it.
All right.
I get a 6 for a smarts check.
All right, so Johnny Moon figures out he's just got to disengage a couple different the belts from the pulleys. The blade stops. And all is quiet for the moment.
Except for Wan Lo on the floor bleeding. Does anybody have first aid?
No.
Oh, and Wan Lo is bleeding on the floor?
Yes.
Wan Lo has 2 wounds.
Oh, no! Juan Lo, I'll help you! Now, if I remember correctly, I have to apply pressure to the wound to stop the bleeding.
Oh, come on.
Has anybody got any rags?
Don't you have any of that stuff that's going to burn like hell when you spray it?
I understand, Edison, if you just pack sawdust in there really good, it'll soak the blood up and stop it.
It's mostly bludgeoning damage when you think about it. It's a wood golem that decked you. So
I don't seem to remember that.
There's
in
a
first
lot of splinters.
But hey, there's still the opportunity to do first aid if anybody.
Does anybody have first aid?
Not that won't prevent you from doing it. Just might prevent you from succeeding if we have, especially if we have no supplies.
I have a repair.
Isn't that a -2? Repair human.
Edison's got first aid. He just rolled a 6 explosion and then a 2 after that for a total of 8 healing.
All right, minus the wounds I have is a
six.
Now, what's the negative for not having any? Do we have any supplies?
There's no bonus. I think it's supplies is your bonus.
I thought it was the other way around. I will look it up because I've got a fast tablet now.
Wow, we have not actually had to do healing ever like this. Have we?
Not an ETU.
I think we did in a pirate game that Jeff ran for two sessions. We had healing going on there.
I have healing. All right. The golden hour. Natural healing. The healer must subtract the patient's wound levels from his skill roll.
Which he did.
A wounded character trying to heal his own injury suffers from both effects. His wounds plus the wound penalty. Healing requires some basic bandages, some such supplies such as bandages and reasonably clean water. I'll give you the shirts off your backs, and there's the river, the stream outside.
Wanlo doesn't have a whole lot of shirt.
If these aren't available, it suffers a minus two penalty.
Either way, if it's a 6 or an 8, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Because it's going to be either a 4 or a 6, each of which is one wound.
Right. So success on a healing roll removes one wound.
I don't know. Do you want to try again, Bob, or are you going to leave it with one and leave me with one?
I have a bunch of bennies, so I certainly can try again, but I'm not sure if I can roll much better with a D6 healing.
It's up to you, man. However you think is best.
Well, we could try one. We can try investing one. I mean, I did explode, but let me give it one more shot. Hang on. Oh. Oops.
What does that mean, Bob?
Oh, you guys can hear me from the other window. That's good to know. So I rolled again, and I exploded, and then the wild die got a 2. So then I re-rolled the explosion, and I got a 2 again. So I got an 8. Again, I rolled the exact same roll as before.
And unfortunately, my minus 2 leaves us with a still just 1, which is okay.
Well, actually, let me ask you this. If I did a second heal roll... So we roll on the first. Can I roll a second heal roll to heal the second, or no?
I don't think it works that way, although I don't recall specifically.
That would seem abusive. So
yeah,
probably it doesn't work that way. But if you can detract one Benny from me, I'm down to 2. And we gave it the old college try, so you're still down 1.
That's better than 2.
Agree.
All right, looking around, you see the incapacitated body of what you assume to be, based on a picture from his wife, Ken.
We go over there and see if he's
Ken Hart
alive.
Yeah, he's beat up, but he's alive.
We try to get him up.
Yeah, he's Bob, go ahead and give me another first aid check for Ken Grant.
Oh, wait, you know what? I don't think... Oh, that right. Yeah, sorry, Penny.
Let's see here. So, D6, the first roll is a 5. The second roll is a 3. So, not as good for him. I rolled a 5. And then how many wounds he has will determine whether he gets healed.
Right. So, he has more than one wound because he's pretty beat up.
Yeah.
Well, actually, he's not a wild card, so he only has one wound that he's beat up.
Yeah.
You get him back to barely travelable.
Okay.
It's going to be slow going for you guys to get out of the woods.
Ken, can you hear us all right?
Oh, what happened?
Well, first there was a headless gym, then there were a whole bunch of planks, then there was a bit of a fight. Then we had sort of a James Bond action sequence with Roxanne at the center of attention. Then Juan Lo really got hit pretty hard, and evidently you got torn up pretty badly last night.
Wow. So, by the way, Roxanne is completely torn. In her mind, Edison rushed into the fray, was the first one to cut her ropes, but at the same time, Juan Lo took a beating trying to save her. She just doesn't know what to do with herself. She's just bouncing back and forth between the two of you.
Maybe she should go figure that out on her own.
It's sad and disturbing all in the same sentence. I was so wrong. I never should have done that.
Definitely disturbing.
Dude,
what did you do, Ray?
Do you have the hook? I gotta return that. That was, I don't know what I was thinking. So I assume you picked up the hook.
I believe somebody did say they picked up the hook.
Okay.
I think it was Mike.
I actually used "What did you do, Ray?" at work the other day.
It's like you're talking about that.
So, all right.
Bob, you don't have the healer edge, do you?
No.
Checking. That would have been nice.
Well, something to think about for next level. I don't know if that totally meshes with his other skills, but definitely we'll think about it.
Sorry, at any rate.
All right, at any rate, you guys retrieve him. He has a small backpack with him with stuff.
Does it have healing supplies?
No, but there's a couple snacks that he offers up. It's late morning now. You're starting to get a little hungry, especially after all that activity.
Kim, why did you steal the hook in the first place? What were you hoping to accomplish?
So he reads into his pack and he takes out a book. And Edison, give me a notice check since you're so engaged in this.
Okay. Of course, I'm the slowest person to roll the dice since I have to go to another window. I got a
here?
1.
Are you still on your phone?
And a 6, which explodes to a 9.
Are you still on your phone?
Yeah, because I'd have to unpack the backpack and get it all set up, and just easier.
It takes so long to turn on a computer.
For some reason, I always envisioned Bob with a big desktop set up at home. Well, a bunch of monitors, but anyway.
No, I've got I don't actually own a desktop. I have a pretty powerful laptop at home for my setup.
So, all right, so what's your roll, if you notice?
9. I exploded, got a 9.
All right, so you're looking over his shoulder as he's going to this notebook of his. You are impressed with the fastidiousness he has of organization. It's all notes. It's obvious he's completely obsessed and OCD about bloody gym.
Part of that?
He settles on a page and he kind of shows you. You don't have enough experience to understand it, but it's some sort of ritual that you think was involved in trying to summon bloody gym so he could get to meet him or see him or something like that.
Oh my goodness, Ken, I see how you have tracked the phases of the moon, and then you've color-coded for every day of the week, and you've even included what you had for lunch. That is so impressive. By the way, I don't think that is a healthy amount of burritos that you have in your diet.
Yeah,
really,
but this egg salad is really good.
Is this some sort of ritual for summoning Big Jim himself, Bloody Jim?
Well, yeah, that's why I needed the hook so I could tie him, to tie it back to him. So I had a way to call to him through. They used the hook because it was his hook.
You brought him back on purpose?
Yeah,
I lost somebody saving you.
I thought I could.
Two people, you dumbass.
You have a wife and a child. You got to be more careful about those types of adventures.
I didn't think it'd be that dangerous.
You brought spirits from the grave.
I had a summoning circle. I thought he'd be stuck inside of it.
You're playing with the devil's magic, and you think you're not going to get anybody hurt? You dumbass.
Just say I won't be trying that again.
Damn right you won't be trying that again. I'll chop off your thumbs, you dumbass.
Ken, do you mind if we hold on to this? We can give this to Professor Mack, maybe put it in his possession for safekeeping.
But we return it to the rightful owner.
The hook or the book?
The hook.
Well, the hook you should give back to the original owner, which was
really Bloody Jim.
Dr. Rick Barton.
But since we've stolen it off of Bloody Jim's corpse, we'll give it back to Dr. Rick Barton.
And get your reward.
Who was the latest owner.
Yeah, please, you can give it back. I'm going to continue my research, but I don't see myself being this foolish ever again.
Oh, yeah, damn right. And what about the breaking and entering you did? You stole this from the professor's
house.
You
can see he's totally ashamed. He's crushed and embarrassed and ashamed.
Oh, and Wanlo will ride that.
Wanlo rides this guy's ass the next 4 hours.
Broken ribs
are all,
because if he doesn't pay attention, he's going to get fucked hard.
Ken, do you mind if I take some pictures of your work? This is truly outstanding.
Sure, you can take some pictures of the notes.
Thank you, sir. Edison takes a picture with his camera of every page of the notebook.
All right.
I'm going to ask him how we're going to get them their shirts. Night, Amy.
Night.
Hey, good night.
Hey, Bob.
Right. Hey there.
So you guys head on back through the woods.
Amy just got up.
Towards grandmother's house.
The grandmother's house you go.
Juan Lo's limping with his broken ribs.
Not broken, cracked.
Oh, yeah.
Bruised.
Just make sure somebody else is.
I have him leaning on me, and I'm
not
going to go.
No, not strong.
So,
and I'll be
Jeff, give me a tracker roll. See if you guys get out of there on the first night or spend another night in the woods.
Ugh.
I know he's welcome to help him if they have tracking.
I could roll tracking.
Oh, he's rolling more dice.
Seven.
Johnny Moons, Native American heritage, guides you guys through the big thicket. You get back to the cars, and it's obvious that... where is it? You find that Ken's car has definitely... been touched by Bloody Jim. He wasn't taking his car home.
Uh-oh.
He's going to be riding with you.
What is a JMC?
I have no idea, but I saw this picture.
Where on earth did you find that? That's fantastic.
Really, what does it take for that to happen?
Oh, my God, I know, right?
Can you guys all see it?
Oh, yeah.
Mikey, care to guess how that happens?
I can't even imagine. Well, you know, it's an international plate, so God only knows.
So for those of you who's listening, there is a giant 6-foot saw blade embedded in the front of a small foreign car.
It looks like an extended cab.
It probably just fell off the back of a truck.
Yeah. It was just, I couldn't pass up on it.
That's a full 2 meters.
that's a full 6-foot blade. That is a monstrous blade. So, all right. So you get back to campus, and
I go to the infirmary, or
you go get patched up a little bit.
Yeah, let me go there.
You guys visit Rick Barton. He gives you each a $50 appreciation. Thank you for recovering the hook.
And then I go to the infirmary.
Because
we keep track of money.
It's the school infirmary. What happened? We were roughhousing. I might have cracked a rib.
I was in the dorm and I was drinking.
Oh, you were doing martial arts practice.
Yeah, drinking, and because all the good stories have to do with drinking.
All the good stories have to do with drinking.
JMC is a Chinese / Ford company.
No kidding.
Okay, so they are two passes. Wanlo is starting to feel a little better. You guys are settling back in. You haven't seen much of Roxanne.
Woo-hoo.
She's been laying low.
That's good for everybody.
Obviously. Edison was disappointed to find out that, for whatever reason, Anthony's tape did not come out with anything reasonable. It did record a lot of the sounds from the Sasquatch or Bigfoot or whatever it was. But for whatever reason, the activity in the mill trying to save Roxanne came out as all blurry, messy static, and didn't really show anything.
All jabberats.
That incredibly surprising and disappointing turn of events that none of the video came out. Incredible.
We did not see that coming.
So, a couple days go by, and weird shit starts going on.
Again?
Oh, no. Still.
We must be in Pinebox.
So... you guys start to notice things that might have occurred by somebody using a big hook. Scratches down the walls, punctured football.
Wait, punctured football, Johnny.
What?
You'll be in a hallway late at night, and it'll sound like somebody's dragging a hook across the walls.
Wait, is it supernatural, or is it just that a mountain lion has made its way through each of you?
Considering it's happening to each of you separately, never together.
And it's only
usually when you're alone.
And it's only one lion, not three or four. Excuse me.
And out of the corner of your eye, bring me a notice check.
Wait, I'm sorry, what check? What?
Notice.
Wanlo gets a raise.
3.
I rolled an 18.
Chris, did you just type in 7?
All right. So those who succeed with the race check, so 4 or better, would swear that they see Bloody Jim every once in a while with the corner of their eye.
That's
those
just
who
crazy.
Succeeded with a raise are certain they've seen it out of the corner of their eye.
No, it's not crazy, man. I totally saw the guy. I saw him. He looked me dead in the eye. He said, I'm going to summon my minions again.
Wait, when he looked you dead in the eye, was he like holding his head up like at your eye level and then his head was looking at your eye? Or was it like you were looking down around his like waist and he was holding
no,
the head
he was
by
holding
the
waist? Dead, he's holding his head under his arm. So it's kind of like looking then down, sort of dead in the eye, down. Yeah, he didn't have his head on his neck. He was totally carrying his head.
Oh, all right. I see. I was just always wondering how that worked. Okay.
But his eyes were looking up at me, man. They were looking right up at me. And they said, I'm coming back. I'm going to bring my
guys,
minions.
Maybe we didn't get rid of Bloody Jim. Maybe he's still out there and he's still haunting us.
I think we need to destroy the hook. We got to destroy that hook. That's his link to the... That's his link to the world, the devil hook. And what day of the week is it?
When's that?
One of these days I'm going to make it to church. I did go to church on Sunday.
You did.
Should we talk to Professor Mac and see if he's got any suggestions on how we can end this curse?
My character.
Okay. you got back late Saturday night. You made it to church Sunday and you're...
And I'm devout. I've got to play it.
Len Mac is happy to talk to you if you want to reach out to him.
So we go talk to Len Mac.
Hey guys, what's going on? It's good to see you. How you feeling, Juan Lo?
It hurts to breathe still.
Yeah, no, that's the end of that.
I punch him in the jaw.
What can I do for you guys? Dr. Barton is ecstatic that you were able to help him. I can tell you that. I appreciate your help with that because, you know, it's always good to help another faculty member.
Yeah, we need to get the hook back. We gotta burn it or something.
Why?
Because Bloody Jim, he ain't gone, man. You've been hearing about how there were scratches down the hall and stuff, and I saw Bloody Jim. I saw him, and he said he was coming back to us.
Really?
I saw him.
Because...
You guys have been seeing him, right?
I did.
Really? This is fascinating.
I mean, I saw him. I looked right at him, and we locked eyes, you know. He was looking up at me from under his arm, and we locked eyes. And he told me, I'm coming back.
So
we got to get the hook, because that's his link to the devil, and we got to take it back.
So I was looking at some of the notes that Edison forwarded me. Because Edison, you forwarded the notes, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And I don't think you need the hook. I think you just need to find where he was killed and consecrate the ground.
Which the first time or the second time?
Originally.
Oh.
So we got to find one of these, going to go back out in the stupid woods where I already got hurt once, and we got to go back out there again?
I think so. Now, I've been reading through this stuff because he did an amazing job with this. This research is just amazing.
Do you know what he had for lunch?
Yeah, the egg. He really loves the egg salad over at the diner.
Oh, perfect.
Really? Half a sandwich, lettuce and tomato, whole wheat toast, but only half. I don't know why only half.
I never would have thought about egg. That's good. Goat without cheese. I want a tuna melt. Anyway, sorry.
But it looks like, according to his notes and what you've described to me, you almost made it to before you backtracked to find that Roxanne was missing. You were a couple miles away from a different lumber mill, and I think that's probably the place where it was. I'm happy to come help you do this, because if I can help settle down the ghost of Bloody Jim.
I just realized that where my voice kind of came from. It was actually a Chinese guy I went to college with who was in a group of mine. Just occurred to me.
Jeff's fading.
Faded.
No, a little bit.
Chris got quiet too, so.
Yeah.
No, I'm still here. I'm just listening.
Okay. I didn't realize there's a guy in that picture with the saw blade in the background.
Oh, yeah.
So,
hey, Bloody Chip is in the picture. He's hiding behind the car.
All right, so this sounds like it's going to be a walk, though. So let's get prepared. We'll meet tomorrow morning and go.
I bring water and a first aid kit.
Guys, I'm thinking maybe, do you remember when we did the scavenger hunt? We met that fella who sells weapons. Maybe we should get something more official. It seems like every time we go out for a weekend or in some stranger's van, we end up getting attacked. Maybe
we should
arm ourselves.
Next time, I
need to buy some more bullets.
Next time we go in a stranger's van, that stranger better have candy or I'm not going.
So I propose we go back to that guy with the ponytail. You know who I'm talking about?
It's Texas. There's one guy in the whole state with a ponytail.
I think he had a ponytail. All
right, so there were two places you could get a gun. I'm looking up the places. Hold on a second.
And Juan Lo, do you think that you might be able to swing by the church and see if you could procure some holy water for us? Maybe that would help.
You want to steal from the church? What, are you crazy? I'm not stealing from the church. This
I'm not saying you're
wrong,
stealing
man,
from the
bad.
Church. I'm saying that you're using the tools of the church to fight evil. That seems like they would be willing to allow you to arm as a warrior of God himself, no?
You know, let me talk to Reverend Johnson. I ask him. I'm not going to steal nothing, but I ask him if I could take some of the holy water from the font.
But it's a shot. It's worth a shot. I don't know if it'll work. I've seen it on TV.
I ask him. I'll tell him what we're doing. I'll tell him we're going to consecrate some ground where Bloody Jim died, and we'll see what he says.
All right. So there is the Pinebox Fishing and Hunting Store, which stocks everything.
Fishing and hunting gear?
You got it. And there was Pinebox Pawn.
Which stocks fishing and hunting gear?
As doc, the exact quote is, "We buy and sell everything your heart desires."
At a 20% markup.
I think it was at the pawn shop, but I can't remember the character that we first met.
Oh, wait a minute.
There was a third. There's one more pawn shop. I'm trying to find. There were two places you could buy stuff outside of the regular place, because the second place was run by the total hick. The four kid up pawn. That was Kyle Sibley, who was the. I have his picture right here. I can show you. Total garbage.
Oh, that's a.
That dude's nose is so broken.
Oh, yeah.
He has. You remember seeing a lot of guns at his store. The other store, not so many.
Juan Lo doesn't go in there. That'll get a better deal if Coaches and I aren't in there.
He was kind of racist, wasn't he?
I don't know if we ever actually determined that, but we thought he might be. I don't recall.
Totally.
Oh, he was?
Oh, yeah. Totally, okay. Totally didn't want to deal with China, man.
Thanks, you arrogant prick. And anything we keep Jeff out of at this point is going to be good for him.
So you got the four kit up pawn, which was Kyle Sibley's pawn shop. You have the Pinebox Fishing and Hunting, which would probably be the most legit place. And then you have the Pinebox Pawn. We buy and sell everything your heart desires.
I'll take a blonde, 5'11".
That's actually at the Brazen Hussy Brewery.
That is the Brazen Hussy. I'm on the Brute Squad. I am the Brute Squad.
You are the Brute Squad. So, where are you heading?
I would think that the pawn shops would probably ask the least amount of questions, whereas the hunting shop might ask more questions if we're all in there trying to buy weapons all at the same time.
I don't know, man. It's Texas. They might not.
That's true. I'm just thinking the pawn shops, you know,
maybe
might be.
Have so much whiskey.
I agree. I think pawn shop would be a very interesting place to visit.
The pawn
that
shop would be
I think we should chop around.
We might could find something like a old Commodore 64 as well, and afterwards we could have like a gauntlet tournament. Wouldn't that be fun?
Bob, you sound like Gladys from Portal.
Hey, Bob, Mike, you talk.
Okay, hold on a second.
It's everybody.
Everybody's host. Can you guys hear us okay?
Amateur science.
That's totally. It's from a video game. You wouldn't understand.
I'm sorry.
We kill because we can.
Wow, this is bad. I can't hear them at all. I can't understand them at all.
I can't understand them either, except for aperture science.
You want to disconnect quick? And I feel like it's a foreign language.
Totally.
I don't understand
wild.
Anything.
I should record some of this and play it back to him.
I am.
Oh, yeah.
So.
Either disconnect. It's got to be the thing. Your connection to the server has been interrupted. Digital. It's a local LAN issue.
Digital.
So, yeah, I would say disconnect.
You just dropped out, Adam. Yeah, mine. I'm still up. Guys, I'm going to drop out and try to get back into the Hangout. If I kill the Hangout, I'll invite you right back. All right? All right. I just dropped out. I just closed the window. Can you close your window?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't want to do that.
Oh, I got here too. Your connection to the server was interrupted. So whatever it is, it's something definitely in your whole house.
My stuff never goes down.
I didn't say it was your stuff that went down.
Wow. My stuff's down. Or Google Hangouts is hung. I got in the Roll20 okay, but I can't get back in the Hangout. Error timed out on Google Hangouts. That's weird. Let's try this one more time. Did my internet go down?
I can't even connect to google.com.
I must be caching Roll20 for me.
That's taking a long time to bring up the page here.
Yeah. Did we forever? I went to IBM. I was at IBM as a test because that never goes down. IBM came up, but it's extremely slow.
I wonder if I get to hang out from my phone over the wireless. It's going to have to log back into Hangouts. Bob can hear us a little bit.
Can I bring this back up?
I see you saying it looks like a Comcast issue here. Hold on.
You guys are having trouble too?
Yeah.
Did you just lose TV?
So I have sound, but it's completely black, and I was trying to access on demand, and it wouldn't, so I just turned everything off and turned it back on, and the TV's black, but I can hear the news just fine.
Yeah, we lost everybody.
Including Jeff.
Definitely a Comcast issue then. Okay, so I got you, Adam, for that.
It's slow as dirt, though. I mean, how long for this page to come up? Far too long.
Try IBM. That's what
I do. I do CNN, because it's got a timestamp.
Oh.
At least it used to.
Maybe not a bad sign for them. I don't think we have a choice.
That's interesting that you can still see it, though. Are you, yeah, because you're still on your wireless network. I'm disconnected, so I'm going through the cell here.
Who said that? Oh, Bob.
Bob.